We are 2 months into the hurricane season, but traditionally August and September, the busiest time of that hurricane season. And to mark that occasion, the Weather Channel begins Hurricane Week tonight. Jim Cantore in New Orleans, where I'm sure Katrina memories, flooding memories still very fresh in everyone's mind. That's kind of an issue that we have a lot here in North Carolina, right, Jim?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, what scares me about this year, Wes, quite frankly, is the fact that we've had such a wet summer across the eastern part of the country, especially the southern Appalachians. If we get a hurricane that comes up, especially in the next couple of weeks, you know, all these pre-existing conditions may lead to excessive flooding. If you remember Irene, for example, in Vermont back in 2011, I think it was, we had so much rain in the month of August, and then here comes September and Irene over the top of that. Boom, we got a 500-year flood on our hands. So North Carolina, Georgia, Tennessee, especially western South Carolina, all these areas have been so soaked this summer. I think it would just make a disaster if we got a slow-moving tropical system up in the southern Appalachians.
Yeah, let me ask you about the rest of the hurricane season. Last week, huge dust cloud off the coast of Africa.
Oh,
is that
yeah.
going to put an end yep. to the hurricane season for the next couple of weeks?
Well, that dust cloud's already kind of come across, and it's moving through the Caribbean right now. And so it's dispersion. Behind that, dry air. So neither one of those things are favorable for tropical development. As we get into about August 15th or so, the atmosphere is over the tropical basin is going to moisten again, and I'm sure we will have a steady line of waves coming off the African coast that may develop. So believe me, we're already ahead of the game. Yes, it's nice to have this two-week break, but I have a feeling it won't last.
One of the things the Weather Channel did as part of Hurricane Week, you created a top 10 most vulnerable and overdue cities for a hurricane strike. North Carolina wasn't on that list. I'm kind of surprised. Are you?
I am surprised. Absolutely. With the buildup, especially Wilmington, Wrightsville Beach, those areas, again, hit back in the 90s. You know, Floyd, obviously a big impact for the Carolina. I mean, you know, it's hard not to hit eastern North Carolina, especially. Getting one inland, it's a little bit more difficult because typically they're on that climatological climb toward the north. But, yeah, I'm a little surprised at that, too. I think especially the South Carolina coast is way overdue, way overdue.
And Jim, I'll get you out of here on this one. A little bit of switching gears. Probably the most talked about weather event the last couple of weeks. Sharknado. How mad are you that you are not involved in that?
Well, you know what? I'm going to be honest with you. I actually sat down with my girlfriend the other night and tried to watch this show, and I just, as a scientist, I just couldn't do it. It was just pathetic. It was just absolutely, and it just, you know, it was just too stupid to watch. All right. But yes, would I have loved a cameo in it? Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, why not? You know, why? Would I have loved to have been eaten by a shark? Absolutely. Even if it was make-believe. So, yeah, I was a little upset.
All right. Jim Cantore getting ready for Hurricane Week on the Weather Channel in New Orleans. Thanks for joining us.
My pleasure, Wes.